So now let us start with the programming screencast of Facebook sentiment analysis. I hope you have watched the previous videos. If you haven't, I suggest you to watch the previous videos and then start with the program of Facebook sentiment analysis. I think you all know what is sentiment analysis now. So what is basically sentiment analysis? Sentiment analysis helps you to figure out whether a piece of text is positive, negative, or neutral. Yes, Facebook sentiment analysis will help you realize the sentiment analysis of your Facebook data. So first of all, you need to download your Facebook data. The steps have already been explained in the previous video. So you first download your Facebook data and store it in an Excel file. You download your Facebook data and store it in an Excel file. We'll be using this Excel file in our program. So as already explained, you first need to import the pandas library. So I'll just write import pandas as pd. Then you also need to import the NLTK library, which will help you in sentiment analysis. I'll write import NLTK. After that, you need to import the Vader library. So what do you need to do here is, you write from NLTK dot sentiment dot Vader import sentiment intensity analyzer. So you need to import these three libraries, pandas, NLTK, and from Vader you need to import sentiment intensity analyzer. Then I asked you to download the Vader lexicon. You can download directly from here. I'll just write the command. Please pay attention. I'll write NLTK dot downloader dot download and in bracket you need to write Vader underscore lexicon. Lexicon basically acts as a dictionary here, so you need to also download that. For downloading the lexicon, you have a command NLTK dot downloader dot download, and in bracket you need to write Vader underscore lexicon. Then I'll load my file here. What my file name is data underscore file dot xlsx. This is my file name. In the previous videos, like in speech recognition, you had a doubt that where do we need to store the file which we are going to use in the program. For example, in speech recognition, we used audio file. All of you had a doubt that where do we need to store that file. Actually, you can store that file anywhere in your system. The bottom line is you need to provide proper path to your file. Yes, you need to provide proper path to your file. For example, here my data underscore file is in downloads. So I'll give a proper path here. The path here is basically user Simran Setia, that is my username. Then in that I have the downloads folder, and in that I have my data file. Okay, so I hope that is clear to all of you. You need to provide a proper path. Okay, you can store your file anywhere, but you need to provide proper path in your program. So I have loaded my file, that is done. It is basically XLSX. So I've imported the libraries. I've also downloaded the Vader underscore lexicon, and then I've also loaded my data file here. So next, what you need to do is you need to read from the Excel file. So I'll just write Excel is equal to PD. I'll use pandas library to read my Excel file. I'll write Excel file, and in bracket, where is my Excel file? It has been loaded in the variable file. So what this is doing, this is reading from the read from Excel. I repeat, pandas library will help you to, it is basically pd dot Pandas library will help you to read from the Excel file. So you will write pd, because I have imported pandas as pd. I'll write pd.excel file, and in bracket I'll write my file variable name, and that is file here. Okay, so I have read my Excel file with the help of pandas library. As I already said, pandas provide you with easy to use data structures. So we'll be parsing this Excel file and converting this Excel file to data frame. What is a data frame? As explained, data frame is a two-dimensional structure in the form of a table. So data frames will help you to analyze your data easily. As you all know, pandas library provide you with this facility. You can convert your Excel file to some other data structure which are easy to analyze. Yes, so we'll be converting our Excel file to data frame. So I'll just write dfs is equal to excel dot parse, and I'll write excel dot sheet underscore names 0. Here we are storing our information in the first column, so I'll write 0 here. I'll just show you. For example, in the first column only, I have stored all my post information. You can see here, I have stored all the information in the first column, so I'll write 0 here. So I'll write hash. What is this statement doing? Parsing the Excel sheet to data frame. Parsing the Excel sheet to data frame. Next, what you have to do here is you need to update your data frames as per your requirement. For example, here I have some blank rows here. As you can see, I have some blank rows here. I need to delete this blank rows from my data frames. So I'll just write dfs is equal to list dfs, and in square brackets I'll write timeline, because that is the name of my column. Okay, and then I'll also print all the DFS. So what it is basically doing here is it is removing the row from the data frame. I'll write it removes the blank rows from the data frame. So we will just run our program here and see how data frames are coming. So I'll just run. I first need to store my file. I'll store facebook.py. So as you can see, I have my data in the form of data frames. Whatever has been written in the Excel file is here, because I have converted that Excel file to data frames. So we have the data frames here. Now we have the data frames. So next step would be analyzing them. So we'll do sentiment analysis on these data frames. So what will I write here? First of all, I'll initialize my sentiment intensity analyzer. I'll write SID is equal to sentiment intensity analyzer. Then, as you can see in my Excel file, I have this information too, that when my post was posted. For example, the particular time and the date has already been written. So I need not analyze this information, the particular time information. So what will I do here is, whenever this sentiment analyzer would encounter this, the timeline information, the time information, it won't analyze it. It will only analyze my post. Okay, I repeat here. For example, I have here Monday, March 27, 2017. So this has nothing to do with sentiment analysis. So I'll just remove this. I'll not remove here from the Excel file. I'll just hard code it in my program, so that whenever my program encounters this particular statement, this time information, it skips that information and it doesn't do sentiment analysis on that information. So I'll just write here I'll store it in str1. So what is the information? It is basically UTC plus 0530. So it may be different for your Excel files. So you need to check in your Excel files. If there is such kind of information, you can skip that information because this has nothing to do with the sentiment analysis. So now I'll write for data in DFS, A is equal to data dot find str1. This particular command will find str1 in my Excel file, in my data frames, and if it'll basically return a boolean value here. For example, if it returns -1 here, that means it hasn't found that str1 in that particular A. For example, here I have the data, and if it encounters this particular line Monday, March 27, 2017, and it has encountered this str1 also here. So it won't return -1 here because it has found that UTC plus 530 here. But if it hasn't found that UTC plus 530 here, that means it is an information that needs to be analyzed. That we need to analyze this particular information. We need to perform sentiment analysis on this particular information. So if it hasn't found this str1, that means we need to analyze that particular statement. So I'll just write SS is equal to SID dot polarity underscore scores data. Whatever data it has encountered, now it needs to be analyzed. We need to perform sentiment analysis on it. So it will print the data here also. Print the data, and then for K in SS, write print K and then SS of K. It will basically print whether a given information is positive, negative or neutral, and it will also print the intensity of the sentiment too. I'll just run this file, then you'll get to know what I'm trying to say here. So I'll just run it. Let us run this. So super, we have all the information here. We have all the timeline information here. So for example, my first post was this: Rohit Sharma wants to read the murder of Roger, whatever it is. And then it has given the polarity also, that it is 0.251 negative, it is 0.749 neutral, and it is 0 positive. And it has also given some compound information. Compound information is aggregate of all the sentiments. For example, it is negative also and it is neutral also, but the compound information says that it is -0.69. That means it is negative. So similarly, in the forthcoming post too, it has written that it is 0 negative, it is 0.721 neutral, and it is 0.279 positive. And it is also given the compound information, since the negative value here is 0 and it is positive. So the compound information, the compound sentiment is also positive here. So it has analyzed each and every information given in the Excel file, and it has written that whether it is negative, neutral, positive, and also the compound sentiment that we can figure out from this information. So I think now everything is clear to you guys. I'll revise the each step here also. So first of all, what you need to do here is you need to import the libraries. Basically, you need to import 3 libraries here. You need to import pandas, you need to import NLTK, and you also need to import Vader here. So I have imported these 3 libraries. I have downloaded the Vader underscore lexicon. You also need to download that. And then I need to load the file here. Since I have already explained, you need to provide proper path to your file. You can store your file anywhere in your system. Then I read from the Excel file. After reading from the Excel file, I parse the Excel file to data frames. Yes, data frames is the facility that has been provided to us by the pandas library. Data frames are basically a two-dimensional structure in the form of a table. It makes the analysis easy. And then I have removed the blank rows that are present in my Excel file. So this is how you do it. After that, I have printed my data frames, that each and every data frame is printed here. After that, I've initialized my sentiment intensity analyzer. And then I have explained you guys that in my Excel file, I've also the time information, the time at which my post was posted on my timeline. So I need not analyze this information. This has no relevance. So whenever my program encounters this particular STR, that is the time information, and then it skips that particular statement and goes to the next statement. So for that, I have taken a variable A here. Whenever in my data STR1 is found, and if STR1 is found, it needs to skip that. For example, that means if its value is -1, it hasn't found that STR1. Yes, I repeat, if its value is -1, it hasn't found that STR1. So now I need to analyze that particular statement. So if A value is -1, that means it hasn't found that particular statement, that particular time information. So I'll just analyze that statement. For that, I need to write sid.polarity_scores, and in bracket you need to supply data. Then I have printed that data, and then for K in SS, I have printed the particular K. K will denote here whether it is negative, neutral or positive, and SSK will tell you the intensity of that particular sentiment. So K here is the sentiment, SS of K here is the intensity of the sentiment. I hope that this programming screencast was useful to you guys and you have understood it well. And if you have any doubts, please post on the discussion over forum. We are there to help you. Thank you so much.